person, PPL 421, number one. And today you're going to be viewing a video where we'll be having the introductory lecture on the course. We're going to be looking at the basic principles of land law. I encourage you, watch the video to the end, take part in all the activities. If you have any questions, send them to the discussion forum and then we'll talk about it. So let's begin. Okay, so you're welcome. Now, the first thing we're going to look at is, what are the sources of Nigerian land law? Now, you have four major sources. You have customary land tenure, that's customary law, which is different in different communities in Nigeria. Then you have the received English law, made up of common law, rules of equity, and statutes of general application. The limiting date being 1st of January 1900. Then you have Nigerian legislation, statutes, subsidiary, subsidiary and primary. Most importantly, the Land Use Act. Then others like registration of titles law, property of conveyancing law, and conveyancing law, the constitution, and so on. And then you have Nigerian case law. What is land? Now, people generally see land as the ground, you know, that you see, and the subsoil, but it's more than that. Land, when you are defining it legally, includes objects that are attached to the soil, whether naturally or artificially. Note that those are permanent objects only. And then abstract rights, like rights of way, easements, sacred customary rights, which all these rights, abstract rights, are usually are intangible. You can't see them, you can't touch them, but they come with ownership of land. There are rights attached to land. And you must note that under the Interpretation Act, the definition of land does not include the minerals. Of course, you know that minerals are strictly within the preserve of the federal government through the Minister of Minerals and Mining. So, the quick read rule. This is a Roman maxim that says, quid quid plantator, solo solo sed it, meaning that whatever is affixed to the soil belongs to the soil. And the rule only applies to permanent structure. That is why we use the word affixed. The quick read rule, there have been questions whether it is applicable under customary law. It being a maxim of Roman origin that was imported into English law. But the authorities generally agree that it applies. Authorities like Elias, Koka, and Olawi have agreed in the affirmative that it does apply under customary law. But Lloyd says that it does not apply. Now, the Nigerian courts have fixed to rest the controversy and stated clearly in the cases of Osho and Olayoye and Ezoni and Ijodike, you will find where the courts made express pronouncements on the applicability of the quick read rule under customary law. And they said, yes, the quick read rule applies under customary law. So let's quickly go to your first activity for this lesson. Okay, so moving on, another concept we'd like to look at today is the concept of title. Now, title is defined as the existence of facts on which right of ownership and possession may be inferred. You must note that when you hear the word title under land law, it doesn't only deal with the rights of ownership. Someone in possession will also have title. So you hear when you're talking about title, you may ask, what title does someone have? And they say, oh, he has a sublease, or he has an assignment or something. Those are types of title. So title really refers to the degree and forms of control, use and enjoyment that will be recognized and protected by law over land. And as I said, we said it may connote ownership and it may also deal with possession. Title is of two types. There's absolute possession and there's restricted, there's absolute title, which of course is ownership, and there's restricted title, which only gives possession rights, possessory rights, but doesn't give ownership rights. Also, title may be original or derivative. When it's original, an example of original title would be like ownership of land through conquest, settlement, and so on. And where it is derivative, it means title is obtained from a third party. So that would be transfer, inheritance. Now, what is ownership? We have been talking about ownership. Ownership, what does it mean? Ownership is defined as complete and total control exercisable over land. It is superior to possession. It is a right to use land however the owner likes, whether it is positive or negative. It is land and he can do with it what he wants. And that was stated in the case of Abraham and Olorun Femi. And of course, you know that by virtue of Section 1 of the Land Use Act, which you must have learned in your land law, that the owner of land is now the governor because all land has been vested in him. So really, strictly speaking, the concept of ownership for individuals has been modified by the Land Use Act. Under customary law, we know that ownership is usually vested in the family or the community. The concept of individual ownership first would only be ascribed to the first settler of the founder of a family or community before the community, you know, came into existence. Subsequently, what now exists, it will be corporate ownership. Because land is sacred, land is not just any other type of property. Whoever holds land is believed under customary law to hold it in trust for generations yet on. So what is possession? Possession refers to physical control or occupation of property. It does not need to be full ownership. In other words, an owner may be in possession or have possessory rights, or he may pass with his possessory rights. He may alienate his possessory rights to a third party for a definite time. And possession is protected by law when it is exclusive. So there are two types of possession also. Possession can be lawful or it can be unlawful. When it is unlawful, that's when we talk about adverse possession. Lawful is where someone is in possession having been lawfully allowed to be there. So the owner of land or whoever he alienates title to will be lawfully in possession. Adverse possession, an example would be a squatter or a trespasser. They are not in possession because they have been lawfully licensed to be there. Now, the rights of someone in possession include the rights to be able to exclude all intruders. Of course, you will not call the owner where the owner of land alienates a possession to a third party for a period of time. You will not refer to the owner as an intruder. So this exclusion right may not apply to the owner of land. And then whoever is in possession of land is more likely to be presumed to be the owner of the land, you know, except of course where someone with better title comes up and proves better title. Now, acts of possession, remember we said possession is physical control. So what are the acts that will show that a party is in possession? It may be by building. It doesn't necessarily have to be by the person living on the land or building completely in it. So while building is okay, fencing is an act of possession. Demarcation of the land by pickings and so on is an act of possession. Putting sand on the land, bricks on the land, clearing the land and all of that are acts of possession. On that point, we will look at the case of Ruta Ofe and Dankwa, which is a Ghanaian case but has been extensively referred to in Nigeria. And now to your second activity. I'd like you to think about it again, what we have talked about, title, ownership and possession, and then look at this statement and tell me what you think of the statement. An owner need not be in possession, but a possessor need not be the owner. Let me read it again. Statement is, an owner need not be in possession, and a possessor need not be the owner. So in your own opinion, how correct is this statement? So I'll give you a few minutes to think about it and then we'll move on. And that brings us to the end of this lesson. If you have any questions, if there's anything you're not clear about, well, it's a video, you can watch it again and again, okay? As many times as you want, you can download and watch it so it becomes much clearer. But of course, if you have any questions, feel free, go to the portal and drop a question on the discussion forum and then we can talk about it. Okay, so until again during our next lesson, and please remember to join the online facilitation classes coming up next. So until the next time we'll see, I want to thank you for viewing and goodbye.